to welcome all of you to the 22nd edition of this IEEE International Symposium on the World of Wireless, Mobile and Multimedia Networks. As you know, WoWMoM has a very long tradition and is now considered one of the top-tier conferences for the community of researchers working on all different aspects of wireless, mobile and multimedia communications, as well as pervasive network systems. This year, WoWMoM should have been held in Pisa, Italy, but unfortunately, even though the pandemic condition is slowly recovering worldwide, the restrictions on traveling and on organizing public events, as well as safety considerations for the attendees of the conference, forced us to transform the in-person event to a fully virtual conference. However, I'm very confident that you will find the technical program very interesting and engaging. Thanks to the huge work of all the members of the TPC and our TPC co-chairs. As you know, organizing a successful conference is very challenging, and this is even more true in these hard times. And this would have not been possible without the dedication, effort, and support of many fellow colleagues. And first of all, let me thank our wonderful program co-chairs, Claudio Cicconetti and Dimitrios Kustonikolas. I also want to thank our workshop co-chairs, Anna Guiar and Andreas Kassler, our pitch forum co-chairs, Rui Ning and Carlo Vallati, our finance and registration chair, Yong Liu, the publication chair, Pantelis Frangoudis, and our publication co-chairs, Arash Asadi, Erini Eleni Siropoulou, and Yang Liu. Last but not least, I want to thank Marco Conte Sajal Das, the members of the steering committee, for the invaluable guidance and the critical decision that we have to take for the organization of this event. I want also to thank the technical sponsor of this conference, the IEEE Computer Society and the Missouri Science and Technology University, as well as our Platinum Industrial sponsor, Cisco, for financing the Best Paper Award that we'll announce on the last day of the conference. Last but not least, I want also to thank all our technical assistants that will help and support the session chairs in the following days on managing the video conference platform. I think that most of you have already participated to all the online conferences in the last year and a half. And we know that this is not an easy experience, but we did our best to make that an engaging experience also. So we have created a dedicated Slack workspace that will be used for offline discussions. There are several channels in this workspace, one for each session, the events of the conference. Although the technical presentations will be given through pre-recorded videos, all the keynotes, the panels, the talks for the industrial experts, and the question and answer times will be live. So I really encourage you to be very active and to fire questions to the speakers. Furthermore, for the attendees who will not be able to participate live to the conference due to the time difference, there are web proceedings are already available, and you should have received the link to the web proceedings. And furthermore, there is a private YouTube channel where all the recordings of the sessions and the presentations will be available for you. Now, without further ado, I will hand over to Dimitrios, who will give you the highlights of the technical program.
Okay, thanks, Raffaele. This slide shows an overview of the program. Of course, you can access it from the webpage right here. The times are in Central European summer time, but if you go to the webpage, to the conference webpage, you can see the times at your local time. So yesterday we started with three workshops and the PhD forum and also the Networking Women event. And in the next 3 days, we have seven sessions of very interesting papers, including session seven, that is the best paper candidate session. And in addition to that, we have two keynotes, one panel and one industry session. We'll talk more about it in the next few slides, and a work in progress session. And of course, All of you must have received from Claudio the participants kit, right? Which is where you can access everything related to the program, the Zoom links, the papers, the videos, right? Claudio keeps sending emails and posting on Slack. So I hope everybody knows now how to access the content, all the content related to the conference. So let's take a look at some statistics. This slide is a pie chart showing the country of origin of the first author. And you can see that WoWMoM is a really diverse conference. 25% of the papers were from China, but then there are many, many countries represented in this pie chart with 11% or less, right? Italy and US had 11%, and then many more countries had actually 8% or 5% or 2%. So I think that's good amount of diversity here. If we take a look at the contributions, we had 146 papers submitted in total, and by that I mean for the main conference and all the affiliated events, workshops, PhD forum, work in progress, and so on. For the main conference, we had 97 received papers, out of which we accepted 22 after the review process. Each paper received at least 3 reviews. And here we would like to thank actually all the TPC members for helping with the reviews. So 22 papers were accepted as regular and 4 papers were accepted as work in progress papers. And separately, we received 9 work in progress submissions, out of which we received 5, we accepted 5. And we rejected, Claudio and I rejected initially 7 manuscripts without reviews as out of scope. In terms of the workshops, they had a total of 27 submissions, out of which 15 papers were accepted for the 3 workshops. And we also had 6 talks in the PhD forum yesterday. Okay, in addition to the papers, we have, we hope, some very interesting invited talks. We start today, later today, with the first keynote by Professor Tommaso Melodia from Northeastern on fully programmable AI-driven and virtualized next-generation cellular networks. And we have a second keynote on June 10th, on Thursday, by Professor Adam Wollitsch from Einstein Center of Digital Future, Germany, on coexistence, collaboration, and transparency in radio communication systems. Between the two keynotes, tomorrow, we have a panel on edge computing. The title is Edge is the New Cloud. It's moderated by Professor Sotiris Ioannidis from Fort and the Technical University of Crete in Greece. And the participants are Ana Juan Ferrer from Atos, Dario Sabella from Intel, Tariq Taleb from University of Aalto and University of Oulu in Finland, and Yingying Chen from Rutgers University. And last but not least, on Thursday also, after the second keynote, we have an industry session with Andra Lutu from Telefonica, Alessandro Erta and Rupak Chandra from Cisco, and Luca Nicolini from Facebook, who will talk about various aspects of, you know, wireless and mobile networking from the industry's view. And then there will be also a mini panel where we will be able to, all the participants will be able to ask some questions to all the speakers. Finally, the last session, the last paper session of the program, also on Thursday, is dedicated to the Best Paper Award. And this is sponsored by Cisco. So we selected, based on the reviews, 3 candidates for the Best Paper Award, extending the QUIC protocol to support live container migration at the edge, fairness in network-friendly recommendations, and service placement and bandwidth allocation for mobile edge computing-enabled mobile cloud gaming. The order is random here. The award will be selected. We have, Claudio and I have selected the committee that will select the Best Paper Award, and the selection will be based on both the papers and the video presentations and the Q&A following each of the presentations. Congratulations to all the authors of all 3 papers. We will announce the winner at the closing remarks at the end of the program on Thursday, and the winner will be awarded $1,500 USD thanks to sponsorship from Cisco. And I think that's all we had to say, right?
Yes.
I hope you enjoy the conference.
It's time to start. We will start the technical program right away without any break. So now we'll